Hi, very good morning, everybody. This is Dr. G.P. Sudhakar, Professor of Management from Hyderabad, India. Right, so in this specific video, I would like to describe how to do primary research. Right, so this is specific to doing research in management discipline or business administration discipline or business research. Right, and also this can be, the same principles can be applied to the social sciences as well. See, this video is about doing primary research in management discipline. See, basically, when we talk about primary research, primary means what? It is the first-hand information. Primary means it is the first-hand information. The primary data what we collect for doing research is the very first time it is collected from the consumers, users or customers or employees. Right, you know, nowadays not only the human beings are the respondents for the primary data. In some of the cases, like where Internet of Things and other automation, Internet of Things and other analytics are used, machines also can give the primary data. Right, in the when we combine research, so the primary data is the first hand information provided by a respondent. A respondent can be a customer, consumer or user of the system, or the employee, or any other stakeholder with respect to related to the business, right? So that is about the primary data, right? See, before proceeding, you know this, right? There is something called secondary research and primary research. See, the output of secondary research becomes input to the primary research. The output of secondary research becomes input to the primary research. What is the meaning of it? For example, you have started with, I will take you through some example as well. I will take you through example how to do primary research by giving an example. See, secondary research, what is that you are doing? Once you have decided a topic for doing research, whether it is PhD research or, you know, it is a research paper, once you have decided, you will be doing literature review, right? With literature review, what do? You find out the gap. Literature gap you are finding out. Next, what is that you are doing after literature gap finding and also using the problem description? You are developing a model, conceptual model of the research you are developing in secondary research, right? Conceptual model means it can be, you know, other models can be mathematical models or any other architectural models, and all different models are there with respect to theoretically. Right, you are developing a conceptual model. Then what is that you will be doing? You are defining the hypothesis. Hypothesis you are defining based on the conceptual model, whatever you are getting. So you define the hypothesis. This is H1, this is H2. This is variable 1, this is variable 2, and this is variable 3. This is the conceptual model you have designed. Based on the literature gap, you design this conceptual model and defining the hypothesis H1 and H2. An example. Right. So next, what do? You will be developing a questionnaire. For example, see, in secondary research, you will stop here. Up to here you will do and stop. After hypothesis or propositions you make and stop the secondary research. You will make the hypothesis and our propositions you make after the conceptual study and review study, whatever you secondary research you do, what do? You collect the journal papers, you go through them,
note down what are the findings of each paper and what is their contribution, what variables they used, what concepts they used, what is the finding useful to your research domain. Then you identify the literature gap, then develop the conceptual model and you develop the hypothesis. Right. So that means secondary research is done up to there. It done up to there, hypothesis definition. So next, what is your next primary research means using the conceptual model and the literature whatever you reviewed. Conceptual 1, 2, right. Using the conceptual model will give you the construct or the variable or the factor, right? This can be a construct, variable or factor, right? Each factor or each variable will have items, different items per questionnaire, right? So based on this conceptual model and literature whatever you collected, you develop the questionnaire, you develop the questionnaire. So this is secondary research and here starts the primary research. Here starts the primary research. Primary research. Right. So, you have to develop questionnaire based on the conceptual variables you have collected here and the items in the literature and you prepare the questionnaire. You prepare the questionnaire. I will take you through an example, okay? Don't worry. You prepare the questionnaire. After questionnaire preparation, what do you do? You administer the questionnaire. You check the questionnaire reliability and questionnaire validity. Questionnaire reliability can be checked using a statistical technique called known as Cronbach alpha. Using a statistical technique known as Cronbach alpha. Questionnaire validity, you can check. For example, you are doing research in IT industry. HR related topic, management topic in specific to IT industry. Okay, then what do? You show your questionnaire, you find out how relevant is the questionnaire you prepared to the IT industry with some HR executives working, 3-4 executives you identify whom you know and show your questionnaire to them. That way, industry specific also you will be checking, that is validity, questionnaire reliability and validity is checked. Right. So once you take the feedback and incorporated changes in the questionnaire, then you proceed to data collection, that is questionnaire administration, that is called data collection. Data collection. So in data collection, what do you do? You have to conduct a primary pilot study, take data from 30-40 people, see the data, how is the data for all the items in the questionnaire. Right, if any items are to be removed, you remove that item and construct the final questionnaire. Final questionnaire, right? So then you proceed to the full-fledged data collection. After pilot study, you proceed to the full-fledged data collection, right? So, how do you collect data? You have prepared a questionnaire, right? You can do in 2-3 ways. What is that? Questionnaire can be uploaded onto Google Forms, onto Google Forms or Microsoft Forms, Microsoft Forms, or you know other tools, SurveyMonkey, like that. There are some other online websites wherein you can upload your questionnaire and give, send the link to the respondents so that online they fill the data. That is one way to do research, collect the data. Second one is what? You take the physical copy of the questionnaire and distribute the physical copy to the people and collect the data. After collecting physical copy, you enter into the online portal. Wherever your questionnaire you have uploaded, enter the data manually. That is manual procedure. Right? That is one way to collect data. Right? So, once you have collected the data, you have to do data preparation. Data preparation. Preparation means what do you do? Is there any missing item, missing data is there? Are there any duplicate data in there? Missing data and duplicate data you will be removing from the data preparation step. In the data preparation step. In the data preparation step. Right. So, after data preparation, what do? You have to apply statistical techniques. Apply statistical techniques. statistical techniques. I will take you through example, okay, don't worry. Apply statistical techniques. Which is a statistical tool? You can use a statistical tool known as Microsoft Excel. Microsoft Excel for simple study. Immediately, quickly you can get the result. Or you know SPSS. There are so many tools, right? R software is also there. So many tools are there. Software, analytics tools, and you know statistical tools. You can use any tool and apply the statistical techniques. Example statistical techniques can be correlation, regression, chi square test, t-test, ANOVA, MANOVA. These kind of statistical techniques you can apply and find out whatever is the hypothesis you have defined. Whatever is the hypothesis you have defined. For example, you want to find out relationship between one variable and another variable. You apply correlation technique. For example, you want to find out what is the effect of variable 1 on variable 2, then you apply regression technique. For example, you want to find out association between variable 1 and variable 2, then you apply chi-square test. Or you want to find out whether there is a significant difference in the values of a variable with respect to respondent's profile, whether it is gender or age group. In these kind of scenarios, what techniques you can use? T-test or ANOVA test. For example, you want to find out is there any significant difference in the values reported by the respondents. You can apply T-test and ANOVA test based on whether it is single valued variable or it is a range variable. Right. So based on that, you have to apply the different statistical technique and find out the statistical values. Next, what interpret the solution and do the findings. Next comes the findings. For example, in regression correlation technique, you apply it. So the correlation value varies from 0 to 1, right? If closer to 1 is the strong correlation, there is a strong relationship between variable 1 and variable 2. Closer to zero correlation coefficient value means low relationship or there is no relationship between two variables. That is correlation. Similarly, regression technique. In regression, significant value, if it is less than 0.05, the variable 1 has effect on the variable 2. So, like that, each statistical technique gives certain interpretation, right? Based on the value come out from the statistical technique, so you have to interpret and document the findings. Document the findings, right? After findings, what you have to do? Whatever you found from your research, right? You have to compare with the earlier studies, whatever have been gathered in the literature review. You have found out research findings for your study, right? Then what do? You compare these findings with already whatever you collected in the literature review, right? So whether some findings will be in sync with the previously studied, previously conducted tests, or some studies, some findings may differ from the previously conducted studies of other researchers, right? So that you specify in the discussion of the findings. In the discussion of findings, you specify whatever your findings are in sync with the earlier studies, whatever findings you are differing with the other researchers, that also you specify in the discussion, right? Next, what? Conclusion and scope for further study. So whatever you have done is your contribution. Specify your value addition. This is what is my contribution with this research, right? Next, specify further researchers across the world can focus on these areas and extend my research. For example, you have considered only three variables specific to doing HR research in IT industry. Otherwise, you might have left 3-4 variables, right? In the future, scope for future research, specify that further research including these three variables also can be done. These three variables also can be done. So, like that, you have to specify. So, this is how you do the primary research, right? See, I will take you through one example, how to do primary research, right? See, basically, let us example, what is the example? Example is relationship between, example, relationship between manager leadership style, manager leadership style and team member job satisfaction. Probably in construction industry or in whichever industry you are interested in retail industry or in power sector, whichever industry you are interested in, you can do. Like, so what is the research problem? You want to find out, is there any relationship between the leadership style of the manager and the team member job satisfaction? Is there any relationship? You want to find out. For example, this is a primary research. How do you do? Right. So, you can name it like, a relationship between manager leadership style and team member job satisfaction in selected retail organizations or in selected construction industry, in construction companies. Like that, you can name the title, the research project. Right. So, then what do you do? For example, this is the model you want to develop. This is the you have to develop model, right? So, first step for doing primary research is you have to have a model, because you will be collecting data. See, for primary research, data can be collected using a survey questionnaire or interviews or by observation. See, you can collect data using questionnaire or interviews or observation. See, observation type of data collection is suitable if you want to write a case study. Similarly, interview technique also is useful if you want to develop a case study. And also, interview kind of technique, there are two types here in interviews. That is structured interview, unstructured interview. In structured interview, you will have fixed questions. And also, you will be using closed-ended questions. Whereas in the case of unstructured interview, you may ask open-ended questions. Means you ask the respondent to freely give the, you won't be having a fixed format of the question or, fixed format to the answer choices in open-ended questions. Right, you seek the responses from the, that is unstructured interview, right. So, like this, different technique, whether questionnaire or interview technique or observation, you collect the data. For example, you have collected data using unstructured interview or observation kind of thing. What type of data you will be getting? It can be a qualitative data. See, then what you have to do? You have to convert the qualitative data into quantitative data. Into, for example, you asked open-ended questions. What kind of response employees will give or respondents will give? Some qualitative comment, some opinion they give. Right? Then you have to convert this qualitative data into quantitative data. That is, conversion process will be there in data. Right? This is also part of primary research. Right? So, I will explain you those things also. Just before that, you see this problem. See this research problem. Finding out the relationship between manager leadership style and the job satisfaction of the team members. Right? Then first what you have to do? For example, you have taken two variables for the research. What are the two factors or, two components you have taken? One is leadership style of the manager. leadership style. Other one is job satisfaction of team member. Job satisfaction. Right. When you talk about leadership style, what all will come into picture? For example, transactional leadership style. Next, autocratic, democratic, situational. Next, servant leadership. You know, some of the leadership follow it, right? Servant leadership or transformational leadership. One of the another style, right? Transformational leadership style. So like this you have got, for example, you have taken only 6 types of leadership styles as items in the conceptual model. Next, how do you measure the job performance of job satisfaction of employee? How do you measure team member job satisfaction? First one is perception. You know, what is he thinking about it? His perception, own perception is one of these measure, right? Satisfaction, perception. Next, performance is one based on which also we can measure the job satisfaction. Next, productivity. Next one is what? Relationship effectiveness. Relationships effectiveness. Relationships effectiveness. These will be the items inside the component and inside the variable job satisfaction. So what is your main objective? You want to find out the relationship between these two variables. You want to find out the relationship. Right. So then what do? You have the model. This is the model. Then what you have to do? You have to define the hypothesis. You have to define the hypothesis H1. What is the H1? For example, transactional leadership style of manager is related to team member job satisfaction. Similarly, H2, what do we define? Autocratic leadership style of, you know, we can take null hypothesis or you know positive hypothesis. We can take null hypothesis. If we take null hypothesis, what do we say? Autocratic leadership of manager is not related to employee job satisfaction or team member job satisfaction, right? So you can take either hypothesis, right? Autocratic leadership style of manager is related to team member job satisfaction. So like this you define H6, hypothesis 6. What is that? Transformational leadership style of manager is related to team member job satisfaction. So like this you have defined the 6 hypotheses. Then what you have to do? You develop a questionnaire. Next comes questionnaire. What you have to include in questionnaire? Under leadership style, you have all the 6 items, 1 to 6. Similarly, team member job satisfaction. Up to 7 to 10, right, 8, 9, 10, 4 items. This side 4 items, this side 6 items. So total 10 items questionnaire you have developed. 6 items this side and 4 items this side, total 10 items questionnaire you have developed. Right. So then what you have to do, collect the data, upload this questionnaire onto some Google Forms or Microsoft Forms. Right, collect the data. Sometimes now, beautiful, the advantage of these tools is you can see the immediately how the respondents, how many people have given this, responded to a specific leadership style. That also you can find by percentages. Right, see here in a questionnaire, for each question, you have to, you can ask, you know, whether, you know, on a scale of 1 to 5, on a scale of, like at scale of 1 to 5, right, each one get the response from each respondent. On a scale of 1 to 5, you rate your manager with respect to transactional style. Transactional style. See, leadership style varies with based on the situation, right? So, no manager will have a same leadership style all the time. He will keep changing based on the business conditions, you know, organizational culture, environment, you know, team dynamics, right? Based on all these factors, the leadership style of the manager keep changes, right? So, that is the reason. What do you do? You ask each question on a scale of 1 to 5. Rate the specific leadership style of manager on a scale of 1 to 5. On a scale of 1 to 5. So, similarly, on a scale of 1 to 5, perception, performance of employee, ask him to respond. Ask him to respond on a scale of 1 to 5. Right. So, for example, we have uploaded the questionnaire onto Google Forms. Next, you can download Excel sheet. You can download Excel sheet. Excel sheet, what will be there in Excel sheet? There will be 10 columns. There will be 10 columns with each item as, each item as column header. Right. With the each item name, there will be 10 columns. Right. Excel sheet. Right. There are 6 items here, 4 items. Total 10 items are there. Data will be there. No, each respondent, whether he rated 3 or 5 or 2, for different items, there will be rating on a scale of 1 to 5. Right, in the Excel sheet. Then, for example, you are using Microsoft Excel. There is a add-on feature in Microsoft Excel called, data analysis tool, add-on tool in Microsoft Excel. So, you upload that data analysis tool, that is easy. In add-on tools, it will be there in Microsoft Excel sheet. So, using add-on tools, you can, this is 10 rows, you got it right. For example, there are 100 respondents. 100 respondents. So, 100 respondents and 10 columns, you will have data. Right. Then, select all the rows and columns in the Excel sheet. Select all the rows and columns in the Excel sheet. Apply correlation technique. Select the rows and columns in the Excel sheet and apply correlation technique using data analysis menu. Right. So, you get what? You get a table. You get a correlation result table. You know, for all the items like this, you get a table. Right. Each correlation value of each intersection will have range from 0 to 1. In between 0 to 1. For example, for situational leadership and performance, there is a, see the intersection, this is situational leadership and here is the performance of the employee. So, this intersection value, if it is greater than 0.75 correlation coefficient value, that means, what is that interpretation? The situational leadership style of the manager is strongly correlated to the job performance of the employee. Job performance of the employee. Similarly, autocratic, for example, autocratic leadership style, see the intersection. And the employee productivity. For example, if it is 0.3 or 0.25, then say that autocratic leadership style of manager is low. Very low correlation to the job productivity of the employee. Like that, you have to put the interpretation. You have to get the interpretation. Right. So this is an example, simple technique. This is an example, simple technique. Right. Using correlation technique. Similarly, regression also you can find. Then if you want to find out regression, what is the hypothesis? Transactional leadership style of manager impacts or affects team member job satisfaction. Right. See, for example, in the Excel sheet, you got 10 columns, right? You want to find out the aggregate value of job satisfaction. You aggregate the 4 columns. You aggregate the 4 columns and find out the correlation once again. You aggregate the values of 4 columns and find out the correlation. Then enter variable correlation relationship with transactional and situational will come. Entire correlation, enter variable job satisfaction, enter variable relation. Otherwise, you get the all the relationships. No, between transactional and others, 4 items, what is the strength of the relationship between autocratic and all 4 items. So that table, you can get it in the correlation matrix. Right. So this is how you do the primary research. This is how you do the primary research. Right. So as we discussed, the primary research data we can collect using a survey questionnaire or, interviews are this thing, right? Observation, right? So observation technique is useful for development of case study, right? So another technique, unstructured question or unstructured question is there, right? In the interview technique. See, for example, I will tell you one study I have conducted where I collected the qualitative data, where I collected the quantitative data. To my students, I gave one question: ask your parents and tell how difficult it is to get earn 1 rupee, okay, and find out what are all the different sources of income for the family, and you submit me an A4 size paper. I gave this question to my undergraduate business administration students, right? So everybody submitted me A4 size response. I asked only A4 size, not more than that. You give me qualitative response. Then what I have done? I have collected the other data. I have given 2 questions. One is, how difficult is to earn 1 rupee? That is the first question you ask your parents and respond. What is their answer? You write it on the A4 size paper. Second question is, what are all the different sources of income your family uses? Right. These are the 2 questions I have given. Right, for second question, first I will tell you, I asked them, right, what are the different sources of income? So somebody told in public sector government job, somebody told government job, somebody told private job, somebody told, no, we are entrepreneur running this construction company, somebody told we are in aqua business, somebody told construction, somebody contracting. So like that, they specified all the different industries wherein they set the startups. Right, SMEs, probably some may be SMEs, some may be medium-sized organizations, right? Some people have operations abroad also. You know, like this different parents' information about their sources of income, I asked the students, submit A4 size paper. Then what I have done in text, converting text into analytics, that's what I am explaining you. How I converted qualitative information into quantitative information. Then what I have done? First, for second question, right, response. So I have note down all the industries, what is specified. This is, we have a startup in food business, hospitality industry, somebody told construction, contracting. So what industries they have specified, I have underlined on the A4 size pages. Then I copied into, I put it into that whatever I have underlined into another paper. Right. So for all the responses, I have underlined that specific test industry, and then I put it into another paper. So like this, at the end of this exercise, I have got around 30-32 different businesses what their parents are doing. 30-32 businesses what their parents are doing. So this is how I converted text into, I have put, different how many people are doing the same business, that then I added that. So similarly, for the first question, what is it? I asked how difficult it is to get 1 rupee, right? So majority of the people, what they have written, it is difficult to earn. So how many is so difficult? One statistical technique I have put like this. I put like this in my notebook. 1, 1, 1, 4. After 4, then mark it 5. So like this, how many people have so difficult? Right. So I have added them. Okay. I have added. So I think more than 100 respondents were there. I have added them. So then what did I do? How many people responded? It is difficult. So total sum of this. So I got some X number.
Right, divided by so many respondents. Why? So I got 70%. 70% of the respondents told that it is difficult. 70% of the respondents told that it is difficult. How many told it is not difficult to earn 1 rupee? So that also I marked. How many told no, exact no? That also I marked. So that is how much percent. Somebody told it may not be that difficult. But then there are challenges, making significant money. So like that, somebody told. So how much percentage is this? That also I marked. So like that, I converted text into quantitative things and found out the statistics. Underlined that specific text, whatever the response, and then statistically found out the some of the yes, some of the no, and some of the which is neutral. So I calculated each one of them and found out the percentages. This is a qualitative data what I have collected. So that is one of the example, right? So that is also primary research, because it is first time I collected the data, right? That is also comes under primary research, right? So primary research is the one, first time we are collecting the data. It is the first hand information, whoever customers, respondents, consumers, users, they provide the data, primary data, right? So this is all about the primary research. What I think I have covered. Just to go through this, right? So please focus couple of minutes. See, in another video I am explaining you how to do secondary research. Secondary research also, 2-3 types are there. So I will explain you what are those 2-3 types of secondary research also. Right, so kindly focus, and whether you will be able to see the board, just check. Okay, kindly focus a couple of minutes and we will move on to the next task. Right, thank you everyone.